Hello students, welcome to another session of Human Resource Management. In this session, we will be discussing about job evaluation. Now, once a right candidate is placed on a right job, the person needs to be duly compensated for the job he or she is performing. In the pursuit of equal payments, there should be established a consistent and systematic relationship among base compensation rates for all the jobs within the organization. The process of such establishment is termed job evaluation. Different jobs in an organization need to be evaluated to ascertain their relative worth so that jobs are compensated accordingly and an equitable wage and salary structure is designed in the organization. Therefore, job evaluation is the rating of jobs in an organization. It is the process of establishing the value or worth of jobs in a job hierarchy. It is an attempt to compare the relative intrinsic value within an organization. Now, there are some of the defined definitions by Dale Yoder. He describes job evaluation as a practice which seeks to provide a degree of objectivity in measuring the comparative value of jobs within an organization and among similar organizations. In short, we can say that job evaluation is simply measuring the comparative value with other jobs so that the person who is working more will be paid more. Another definition by Edwin B. Flippo defines job evaluation as a systematic and orderly process of determining the worth of a job in relation to other jobs. Again, this definition is showing a comparative analysis between the different jobs, and on the basis of compensation, we can provide the relative worth, or worth is found out on the basis of compensation. Another well-known definition by International Labour Office says job evaluation is an attempt to determine and compare the demands which the normal performance of a particular job makes on normal workers without taking into account the individual abilities or performance of the workers concerned. Now, from these above definitions, we can say that job evaluation is used to establish the relative worth in a job hierarchy. Now, this is important to note that job evaluation is ranking of job and not the job holder. Job holders are rated through performance appraisal. Job evaluation assumes normal performance of the job by a worker. Hence, job evaluation provides basis for developing job hierarchy and fixing a pay structure. It must be remembered that job evaluation is about relationship and not absolutes. That is why job evaluation cannot be the sole determining factor for deciding pay structure. Now, job evaluation is found out on the basis of, or we can say the starting point of job evaluation is job analysis, and no job can be evaluated unless and until it is well analyzed. It is classified. Now, we can say that job evaluation has three factors, that is on the basis of job analysis, job specification and job description. What is job analysis? It is the process of studying and collecting information related to the operations and responsibility of a specific job. Now, before evaluating the job, it is important to know the particular job and to analyze the job. Analysis means operating and collecting the responsibility or collecting the data related to that particular job. Now, when we are collecting data, we need to know the job description. What is job description? It is an organized factual statement of the duties and responsibility of a specific job. As I have always told, job description is describing the content of the job. Next is job specification. Job specification, it is related to human attributes. It is a statement of the minimum acceptable human qualities necessary to perform a job properly. It is a standard for personnel and designates the qualities required for acceptable performance. In simple words, what we can say is job evaluation is the rating of job in an organization, and it is a process of establishing the worth of the job. Now, job evaluation is incomplete because of job. First is job analysis, then job specification, and then description. And on the basis of all these factors, the job is calculated and the worth of the job is collected. Then comes objective of job evaluation. The main objective of job evaluation, as we can analyze, is to ensure equitable remuneration for the relative worth of every job. The principle upon which all the job evaluation schemes are based is that of describing and assessing the value of all jobs in the firm in terms of a number of factors. Now, these number of factors are all related to only and only the job, the task, the duties. It is not at all related to the human attributes or the person who is doing the job. Now, the objectives of jobs, to put in a more specific manner, we can say first is establishing a standard procedure for determining the worth of the job. Second, ensuring equitable wage for a job and a reasonable wage differential between different jobs. Because of the hierarchy, every person is performing at different level, and as the person is performing at different level, the wages or the remuneration given is described accordingly. Next is determining the rate of pay for each job, which is fair and equitable with relation to other jobs. It helps in eliminating wage inequality, as we are discussing that it finds out the worth, and when the worth is found, there is no inequality. It is used as a basis for fixing incentives and different bonus plans. Incentives, as we have always discussed, is based on individual performance, and when an individual is performing more, he will be paid more for it, therefore giving more worth to that particular job. Then it promotes a fair and accurate consideration for our employees for advancement and transfer. The main objective is to provide information for work organization, employee selection, placement, training, and other similar purposes which are directly related to human resource management. The basic objective is also to provide a benchmark for making career planning for the employees, and it helps in ensure that wages are paid to all qualified employees for the like work. At last, we can say the basic objective lying behind job evaluation is there should be equal pay. Equal pay based on the task, the duties, and the responsibility and the worth of that particular job. Remind you again, it is not related to the person who is performing the job. It is always the job for which the person is working. Therefore, job evaluation is finding the worth of job. Now, coming towards the principles of job evaluation. Now, job evaluation has certain principles, and these principles are supposed to be kept in the mind in the job evaluator, that is the person who is evaluating the job. These principles are not only directive of proper job evaluation, but it also helps in providing the clarity in the process of evaluation. Now, there are certain principles given by Kreese, and these principles are the rate, the job, and the jobber. That is, each element should be rated on the basis of what the job itself requires. That is, there must be certain criteria or rank on the basis of which the evaluator will evaluate the job. Second, the element selected for rating purpose should be easily explained in terms and a few in number, as will cover the necessary requisite for every job without any overlapping. That is, the elements based on which the job will be evaluated should be clearly explained. Next, the elements should be clearly defined and properly selected. As I again repeat, job evaluation is finding the worth. Therefore, all those elements which give worth to that particular job should be considered. Any job rating plan must be sold to foremen and the employees, because the success in selling it will depend on the clear-cut explanation and illustration of the plan. The foremen should participate in rating the job in their own department. Next, the principle is maximum cooperation can be obtained from employees when they themselves have an opportunity to discuss job rating. As we always discuss, that human resource management is only successful when they have effective employees working for them. And since the employees are effective, they themselves know the actual worth of the job. Therefore, their participation in deciding and rating the job will be more effective and will be more helpful to the person who is evaluating the job. Because the person who is actually working will actually know the worth of that particular job. That is what all the task duties and responsibilities are being fulfilled by him. Therefore, there is no harm in asking the person or involving the person whose job is to be evaluated. And next is, too many occupational wages should not be established. It would be unwise to opt an occupational wage for each total of point values. Therefore, at a time, only one job has to be evaluated, and on the basis of the hierarchy, the worth has to be defined. Now, there are various processes and methods of evaluating the job, which we will be discussing in our next session. That's all for this session. Thank you.